In this session, we will discuss blowfish algorithm. Coming to blowfish algorithm, generally this blowfish algorithm is a replacement of DES or ID algorithm. Replacement of DES or ID algorithm, and this blowfish also follows feastal structure. Blowfish also follows feastal structure. In this, the size of plain text is 64 bits. Size of plain text is 64 bits, and key. Size of key varies from 32 to 440 bits. That is, in this blowfish cipher, key size is not fixed. It varies from 32 to 48 bits by default. If you are not mentioning anything, by default the size of key is 128 bit. The size of key is 128 bits. Number of rounds performed are 16. This is the basic information: plain text size and key size, the number of rounds we are performing. So in blowfish algorithm, how the key is expanded? So the main point is how the key is expanded. So the expansion of key is simply our original key is divided into different number of subkeys. Our original key is divided into different number of subkeys. Generally, this is divided into 18 subkeys. Whatever the original key we have, our original key is divided into 18 subkeys. For example, the names are P1, P2 and P18. All subkeys are called P arrays. In blowfish algorithm, all subkeys is called P array. That is, P1, P2 and P18 are called P arrays. Along with this division, that is, along with the division of keys into different number of subkeys, our key is also divided into different number of S boxes. Suppose in DES algorithm we have S boxes. In ID algorithm also we have S boxes. But in the DES algorithm, the S box doesn't depend on key. S box has an individual structure. But coming to blowfish algorithm, we are deriving S boxes from the original key. We are deriving a 32-bit S box, and each X box contains approximately 256 entries. So this is the procedure of expanding key. If you want to clearly specify, to get P1, our original key initialize P array. So blindly the procedure is, first to initialize P array comma S box with some null values. Initialize P array X box. Next to XOR P1 is XORed with first 32 bits of the key. The procedure is, initialize the P array. Suppose to get P1 value, P1, that is old P1, XOR with first 32 bits of key, we are getting new P1. This is the P1 we are using for encryption. Similarly, P2 XOR with second 32 bits of the key. For example, this is the original key. In the key, we are using first 32 bits XOR with P1. Second 32 bits XOR with P2, and so on, we are getting P18. So in simple terms, we are getting a P array of 18, P1 to P18. Now, coming to the concept of blowfish. So blowfish follows feastal cipher. Here feastal cipher means divide the texts, that is divide the plain text into two equal halves. So I am dividing the plain text into two equal halves. Suppose left part, right part. If plain text is 64, this part contains 32 bits, this part contains 32 bits. This is the first step. Divide the plain text into two halves. After dividing, perform XOR operation on the left part. To perform XOR operation, minimum we require two inputs. So perform XOR operation on the left part with P array P1. So left XOR operation of the left part and P1, we are getting the result. After performing XOR operation, we are getting a result. Now this result is applied to a function f. So we will next discuss what is the function f. So after getting XOR result, that XOR result is applied to a function. After applying function, we are getting some output. After applying some function, we are getting some output. That output is XORed with right part. So clearly observe, first left part and right part. For the left part, XORed with P1. Here P1 size is also 32 bits. So size of P1 to P18, each P array size is 32 bits. So 32 bits XORed with 32 bits, we are getting some result. That result is applied to function f. The output of f is applied to right part. Now after performing this operation, this result is moved to left part. After performing this operation, this result is moved to new left part, and this result is moved to right part. After performing the one step, simply exchange the left part and right part. Again apply the same procedure. Suppose apply the same procedure 16 number of times. That means suppose this is the left part, XOR 16 round, P16. We are applying 16th round. In between 1 and 3, remaining 14 rounds are same procedure. Again we are getting a result. That result is passed to function f. That result is passed to function f. And the same manner, this is right part, apply to right part, apply to right part. This is the procedure of 16 rounds. After completion of 16 rounds, we have to apply. There is no swapping. After completion of 16 rounds, there is no swapping. Apply P17 and P18 to each part individually. Suppose I am applying P17 to this part and P18 to this part. P17 to this part, P18 to this part, and getting the result. Suppose this is Li minus 1, Ri minus 1. They are getting Li and Ri. This is the Blofish algorithm. So in simple terms, divide the plain text into two equal halves. That is Fischer cipher. Perform XOR operation of left part with array P1. Right part, after getting the result of F, we are performing XOR operation. Swap the results. The same procedure is continued for 16 number of times. We are using up to P16. After completion of 16 rounds, perform without any swapping. One key is applied to one part, second key is applied to second part. Now our aim is, what is F value? That is, what are the operations that are performed in F? So if this is completed, now we will move to F value. So here F value is, the function F is divided into S boxes. F is divided into S box. This is the function F, divided into four S boxes. S box 1, S box 2, divided into four X boxes. So we are applying left part. So we are applying 32 bits. So now these 32 bits are applied to 4 8 boxes. That means these are applied in the fashion of 8 8 8 8. Our 32 bits are divided into 4 8s. So it takes 8 bits as input and output as again 32 bits. For S box, the input is 8 bits, produces output as 32. Here the function F acts as First 8 bits are applied to S box. In the 32, first 8 bits are applied to first S box. And the 8 are converted into 13 based on this S box. From first part and second part, perform operation. After performing operation, we are getting some result. So again, the result is applied to S box 3. We are getting again some result. That result is applied to S box 4. And finally, we are getting a result. These are the 32 bits. So everyone is 32 bits. So the difference between this symbol and this symbol is, this is XOR operation, this is addition arithmetic. Okay, this is the function of F. F is solved in this fashion. So this is Blowfish algorithm. Compare it to remaining algorithms, this algorithm provides more security because it uses S boxes. The S boxes are completely depends on key. So this is Blowfish algorithm.